We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Good evening and welcome to the show. This is Game On Fan Friday. Desire Derek Ford Mogomisa is my name. On the show today, I do have a couple of people that I am glad to introduce to you. But before we do that, let's watch a little bit of what they are all about. And when you get to see that, then I can come back and tell you who we have. Yes, you'll have to believe it. Two great Africans.
It's a song. Here's a Boué. Boué had a look and saw exactly where he wanted to go.
Boué!
It's in! Nicholas Bendtner. Adebayor's turn. Boué's goal!
Here is Song. Oh, it's lovely. Boué! Fabulous! My word, they're good.
In from Vela. Oh, here's Oshavin. Could be three. Saved and in. Arsenal finally have the third goal. It's Boué. It's 4-0. Two goals for the late substitute. Diab is in the clear. Rolled into Boué. 2-0.
And say to the seven defenders they had inside their own penalty area, how did he get the second shot away?
Forward in support, and he's found him! And he's found the net! And Arsenal! There could be another one now, though, there is!
All right. 10 Arsenal goals he managed as a defender. He wasn't even supposed to be scoring goals, but he did. And later we'll be showing you something that gets to come in from, a striker. But for now, let me get to introduce this gentleman to you. What we do have is Emmanuel Eboué, that is a legend at Arsenal. I just said that earlier and was like, huh. But yeah, I guess that is modesty. We also do have Ibrahim Sonko, who has plied his trade in only England. A couple of people do say Messi is not so good because he's played in one club. We are going to ask you about playing in just one country for at least the bigger part of your career. But gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on the show. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Very good. Yeah. How are you finding Uganda? Ibrahim knows much more about Uganda than you do, so I will start with you. How are you finding Uganda?
To be honest, my brother, he knows well Uganda than me, you know, because when I see him, he knows the way, he knows where you have to go.
Yeah?
Yeah, he knows everywhere.
Yeah, when so you came in, we stood at the front. I now remember that. So he was your navigator.
Yeah. Even today, he showed me the road. I said, wow, brother, you are very, very, very good. So to be honest, you are very happy to be here.
Okay.
And then we say thank you to the Uganda people, mm-hmm. because it's them that opened the door for us to come here.
Yeah.
So we say thank you. We say thank you also to Bungabet, because of them and by the grace of God, we came here in Uganda.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Emmanuel Eboué. We also do have Ibrahim Sonko. Ibrahim, before I even say how are you, I'm going to start off with a short conversation we're just having a little bit earlier. Everyone thinks you are the reason as to why Peter Cech is in a helmet. Why are you that bad?
I don't know. No, it's a funny one. I think, obviously, being African, and playing in that league, playing against Chelsea, something happened to Chelsea in the same game. There was another incident between me and Kudicini, and, people associate the accident from Peter Cech to mine, but really, it wasn't me. I promise it wasn't me.
Yes, there was also a similar incident, but to the substitute goalkeeper, but it wasn't that serious, so...
It wasn't that serious, and fair play, he went for the ball, I went for the ball. He should just protect himself, really, because he can protect himself when he's coming out. He didn't. Hit me shoulder to shoulder, and up on the floor. Mm-hmm. Too big for him. Sorry.
He is. We can see that. We can see that. What did you eat?
Me. Pasta.
to let Africa do that. Yeah, you couldn't have fed on pasta. And that is why I would love for us to start being a professional that got to play in the English Premier League. That is the biggest league in the world, at least commercially, for some of the people. That is a dream come true for you two Africans. How do you even start to dream that I want to play there? Did you even, I'll start with you, Emmanuel. Did you even ever dream that I will play at Arsenal or in the Premier League?
You know, when you are a kid, mm-hmm. you know, your dream is first to go to school, mm-hmm. and then do better there. And then, you know, you never born to be a footballer. Mm-hmm. You born, and then it's after, you think what you have to do. Mm-hmm. You know?
And then so it starts happening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, me, I was going to school first, because that's the problem in Africa.
I'm sorry, I'm being disrupted here a little bit. I am asked to take a short break. When we get back, we're going to get into that story. Coming in from education to you getting to play some football and then going out of Africa to try and earn a living out of football, which is a wastage of time for some African parents even today. Let's take this break. When we get back, more stories for you right here on Urban Television.
It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.